Hey, willkommen zurück. Wir müssen noch aufstehen hier.
What do you want? Babe, it's late. I am. Sure. Are you? Everything good there? Jules? That's good. Okay, Jules.
Delilah seems nice.
Sure.
Bye, baby.
Tag 33.
Is it too much of a pain in the ass to bring supplies all the way up to our towers?
Well, I get my stuff hand-delivered.
Oh, how's that work?
It's the perks of a decade of service. You're out hiking in 90-degree heat, and I get to do crosswords. Isn't life miserably unfair? Anyway, when you find the supply drop, remember it's not just for you, okay? Other lookouts, biologists, a few people get their food there, and I don't want to have to call in for more. There should be loads of good stuff, though. Beans, prunes, jerky. You know, my sister eats six prunes a day. Six. She's, like, really precise about it. She'd be great at this job if she didn't need wheelbarrows full of marijuana to function. So, like, 2 weeks ago, you called me in the middle of the night. You were sleeping, I guess, and all I heard was the name Jules through the mumbles. I just thought it was so sweet. I wanted to wake you up, but then I thought maybe you were having a nice conversation and I'd just be spoiling it. I hope you're doing okay, you know, when it comes to her.
I am.
Good. I'm glad. Look. So, a couple of months before I took this job, I was with this guy, Javier. Ugh, he's incredible, caring, sexy as hell. He was a driller down in Casper. We dated for almost 5 years. I was working with the Wyoming Outdoor Leadership School. I was obsessed with it. I wanted to be an instructor so badly. And I was sure I was gonna marry Javier as soon as I could be bothered. Waltz was also a good excuse to get out of town, drink whiskey in the mountains, cut loose. Then, Javier's brother got killed working in Gillette, and for some reason, I didn't come home. Javier said it was fine, he'd go to the funeral, take care of his mom, stuff like that, it'd be easier solo. When he came back, he left me. I came out here, I lied and told my sister he fucked our neighbor. I've just lied about it for over 10 years. And, for some reason, I wanted you to know. I figured you've told me so much about you, so, you know, there's something about me. We both fucked up.
Naja, ich glaube zwar nicht, dass wir es verdient haben, aber egal. So, dann holen wir uns mal Vorräte.
I got everything I need out of here. Time to chow down.
Just yours, right?
Who do you think I am?
Seat for what might be the biggest fire of the year.
Yeah, it's really going.
I'm gonna call it in. They'll send in a hotshot crew for some suppression, but I bet we'll be stuck with her for the rest of the summer. And she doesn't have a name yet. I usually think of something funny or something practical or a little risque when coming up with them. But why don't you do the honors?
Maybe we call it the Flapjack Fire. Can you sell that as a name?
You really like that, huh?
Yeah, I said I did. It's funny.
Fair enough. Flapjack Fire it is. They'll probably ask me if it was a camp cooking accident or something. So there's this creek down the hill, and, you know what my favorite thing to do is?
What's that?
I love to take a bottle of whatever I have on hand, plunge it deep into the water, and let it chill in there all day. And then, on nights like tonight, when it is so disgustingly hot, I have something nice and cool to drink. I learned that from my sister in Santa Fe. She'd do that with a bottle of tequila near her house and make margaritas the size of your head. You'd like it there.
I'm sure I would. Sounds pretty great.
It is. Are you looking at the fire?
Yeah, I am.
I love how they look at night. During the day, it's just smoke, but when the sun is down, you can just get lost.
Yeah.
I'm glad you're here.
Me too.
I know it's probably been a while since you've connected with someone the way we have. I don't mean to get all heavy, but it's been really nice. I wish I was over there.
I wish you were too.
We could sit outside. We could talk without these radios. We could,
ja, es wird lange brennen, das stimmt.
You're going fishing without a license?
It's one fish, and I'm sick of all the stuff I got to eat.
No, I won't tell anyone you're a poacher. That reminds me, I keep hearing reports from Fish and Game about a problem bear they're trying to keep tabs on. Can you search around the lake for fresh tracks and just let me know what you find? There was a crew burning fire lines out to the east, and, you know, I think sometimes it riles up the wildlife.
Sure, no problem. Remember me fondly.
You are such a drama queen.
I can't believe I'm gonna leave this planet as a pile of bear shit.
Thank you, Henry.
Yeah.
So, sorry, dass ich nicht so viel rede, aber das Spiel spricht für sich. So, wo gehen wir denn hin? Da? Campfire Smoke. Wir gehen mal hier lang. Oh, huch.
Someone left their clipboard out here.
Huh. It could have been one of the fish and game folks. See if there's a name or a credential or something. I can call it in.
What the? It's. Holy shit!
What's going on? You didn't actually find a bear, did you?
Someone has written down what we said to each other, have been saying.
That doesn't make any sense.
I don't talk to the other lookouts as much as I talk to you, not in the same way.
No way.
Wait, hold on. Something's out here.
Henry, I'm worried. You didn't find and eat any mushrooms, did you? I mean, they can be fun, but also, you know, devastating.
I found a walkie-talkie out here, too.
Okay.
It's going shithouse.
Well, get it if you haven't already.
Aua.
Henry, are you there? What happened, Henry?
Holy hell, I got hit in the head. Punched or something by someone.
Are you serious? What the hell is going on out there?
I don't know. Jesus Christ.
Let me get this straight. You found a clipboard with, what, transcripts of our conversations? What else is on it?
I don't know. It's gone, along with a radio of theirs. Somebody out here could have just killed me, Delilah.
I don't... What the fuck is going on?
What's Wapiti Station?
I don't know.
I saw the name Wapiti Station right before I was cold cocked. Does Wapiti Station mean anything to you?
Wapiti Meadow. Maybe it's Wapiti Meadow. It's on our maps. It's not too far from where you are right now. It's north of the lake. It looks like there should be a trail somewhere on the north shore of Jonesy Lake.
I'll start hiking that way now. God damn it, my head.
Are you sure you saw what you saw, Henry? Maybe you pissed off some more campers and they came back to sucker punch you.
Look, I know what I saw. Hey, it was our words with initials for our names, H and D, clear as day.
And you've been feeling okay?
I feel fine.
Okay, I'm sorry, I believe you, but that conversation was from 2 weeks ago.
I know they were. So what's to say that they don't have transcripts from 3, 4, or 5 weeks ago?
Our entire relationship, friendship, our whole summer.
Someone is out here with the walkie-talkie, taking notes and talking to God knows who.
Knopf, das ist hier in die Richtung.
What the hell do you think is going on at this place?
Apparently a lot of following you around taking notes, which is unfucking believable, Henry.
Yeah, you're telling me. Alright, I'm on my way to Wapiti Meadow. I'll let you know what I find.
Okay. There's got to be a reasonable explanation. Also, I'm gonna call around and see if anyone's had anything weird happen to them or seemed spooked. I don't want to make this bigger than it is yet, you know?
Yeah, understood.
Yeah, okay. Hike safe.
So, ich glaube, wir sind richtig. Ja. Müssen jetzt hier irgendwo geht's hoch. Ach, wir sind schon oben.
Ah.
So. Das war ein Foto, was wir brauchen. Ich weiß nicht, wo die anderen Fotos sind, aber okay.
Whoa, Delilah, there's a big chain link fence between me and the meadow. I don't think I can get past it.
A fence?
Yeah.
How big?
Big. It goes off in both directions, acres.
But what the fuck is going on out here?
Whatever it is, someone doesn't want anyone to know about it.
Sometimes biologists will cordon off a little area to study flora or whatever, but that's only a few square feet usually.
That's not what this is.
We'll see what you can do to get past it.
Looks like goddamn Area 51.
Maybe they've got aliens. That'd be exciting.
Yeah, we'll see about that. And the gate is locked up, obviously.
Obviously.
I'll see if I can break in somehow.
All right. Be careful.
Okay. I've given it the good college try. No dice.
Shit.
I don't know how long I can dick around out here until someone notices.
God, if you were an actual firefighter, you'd have that gate down in two shakes. Hey, actually, those guys doing the controlled burn, they might be able to help.
Where are they?
Beyond Ruby River, there's a scout camp. They burned a line a few days ago that should let you hike right to them.
Well, that's great.
If they haven't left, they're probably the type of guys who would help you get through that fence.
So, jetzt müssen wir den kontrollierten Brand suchen. So. Knobe. Ah, du sollst nicht laufen. Schatten. Mensch, geht doch mal weg. So, jetzt wird's nämlich langsam creepy.
Hey, I called around. Things seem normal with everyone else.
Should we call the cops or the Forest Service and let them know this is going on?
Don't you think that would sound, you know, crazy?
Yeah, it is crazy. We have to tell someone.
Tell them what, Henry? Tell them we're being stalked and you were attacked and we don't have any proof?
I don't know. Tell them we're being bothered or something.
Henry, I really like this job, okay? And if I give off even a hint of cuckoo to my bosses, they are never gonna let me come back out here. Do you understand that?
All right. I'm headed toward the camp anyway.
Okay. Keep your radio close to you.
Hey. What you just said, keep my radio close to me.
Yeah?
Before I got attacked back at the lake, I saw a radio on the ground, kind of like the one I use.
And?
Do you think that maybe someone was, you know,
I don't know. What?
Maybe intercepting our frequency with other radios or something.
Henry.
It's just a thought.
I don't even know how you would do that.
Yeah, well, you sound worried.
No, I'm not, okay? Let's not spin out of control. Just keep hiking.
Whatever you say, boss.
Hmm. Ja, oder mal. Da waren wir ja schon, oder? So, mal gucken, wie gehen wir jetzt. Gehen da oben lang. Die Wegfindung ist bescheiden. Mein Junge, du warst doch schon mal in der Höhle.
I know we don't know what's going on yet, but I don't have a good feeling. I don't like feeling vulnerable. It's not like you can just call the police. I was thinking about the Goodwins. It just struck me that if anything weird like this happened to them, happened to Brian, just how scared he would have been.
I'm sure he's fine, Delilah. I mean, don't you think if this started happening to them, he or his dad would have said something?
I don't know, Ned was a weird guy.
No, nobody is that weird. The moment you hear someone in the bushes or get punched from the shadows, you're getting your boss on the phone.
Oh, isn't it? Yeah,
Brian is fine.
I hope so.
It was 3 years ago. He's in high school now. He's on summer break.
Yeah, you're right. You're right.
Henry, wenn du müsstest, du kleiner. Möchte gern Detektiv. So, dann mal gucken. Wir müssen jetzt erstmal wieder hoch zu einem Türmchen und dann muss ich da unten lang. Na komm, schneller hoch. So. Na, das ist scheiße heute sehen. Wir müssen hier gleich lang. Da müssen wir richtig sein. Mein Gott, dieses Gerenne. Okay. Sind nicht den Weg gegangen, aber egal. Geile Mucke. Oh Gott, Mann, dieses Gehacke, dieses Spiel nervt, ey. Mach die noch zu. Hi Ron, ich wünschte mir, die da oben würden uns Funkgeräte geben, die nicht komplett für den Arsch sind. Meistens schreibe ich ja lieber, aber ab und zu wäre es schön, dich sofort erreichen zu können. Meine Schwester hinterlässt mir dauernd Nachrichten in der Zentrale. Sie versteht wohl nicht so ganz, dass ich den Job hier angenommen habe, damit ich Ruhe vor ihr und unserer Mutter habe. Ich sitze schon eine Weile hier und überlege, was ich ihr sagen soll. Habe aber bislang nur eine halbe Flasche Gin getrunken. Ich vermisse dich, Dave. Halt. Aufbewahren. Klopapier. Altes Toilettenpapier. Ich mach mal zu.
I found where they did the controlled burn. I can hike right through here now.
Yeah, normally they wouldn't do that so close to a body of water, but I think they're extra worried about a fire jumping the river and burning up to Two Forks, now that there's someone in it.
Well, I'm extra appreciative of that.
Let's see, the scout camp is southeast of the river. There should be a pond on the way.
Got it. There's some old snowmobiles out here.
That's crazy.
Looks like one of the poor bastards was cruising across this pond and dumped it.
That was not a fun hike back to civilization.
What happens if a controlled burn gets out of control?
Someone gets fired.
Oh, are you serious?
Oh, come on. That one was an honest accident. I'm not even in the mood for wordplay. That's how wound up all this shit has me.
Ach, wir sind ja schon hier oben. Wir müssen erst noch die Brücke melden, die kaputte hier.
The bridge to the camp is out.
Damn.
I'm gonna walk the ravine and see if I can find some high ground to get across.
Good plan.
Und Sprung.
I'm at the camp.
Great. Have a look around. If anyone's still there, they might be able to help.
I'm gonna sound crazy.
Maybe you just ask them to help you get inside the fence. If I didn't know it was out there, they probably don't either.
Yeah, these guys are gone. I found where they were sitting around before getting picked up. Hey, Dee, they left something behind. It's like a mess.
Gruppenführer Grant Carson, 10.8.89, Einsatzgruppe. Flächenbrandbekämpfung Wyoming. Paint Rock Ranger Distrikt 1220 Nord 8. Straße. Creed Bowl. Washington 82426. Betrifft Dr. Simmons, Waipiti Station, Region Toro Faro. Gruppenführer Boss Carson. In den kommenden Tagen werden Sie und Ihr Team in der Region Toro Faro im Sonnet Starts Forest eingesetzt, um südlich des Rabi River eine Feuerschneise anzulegen. Ich schreibe Ihnen im Auftrag von Dr. Ben Simmons, Waipiti Station. Er wandte sich wegen der möglichen Bedrohung seiner Forschungseinrichtung durch einen Flächenbrand an den Oberbrandinspektor. Bei ihrer Rückkehr wird ein Mitarbeiter seines Büros die bezüglich einer Gefährdungsbeurteilung für die Region kontaktieren. Ich habe Ihnen bereits mitgeteilt, dass kein Grund zur Sorge besteht und die Feuerschneise ihres Teams eine äußerst wirkungsvolle vorbeugende Maßnahme zum Schutz ihrer Einrichtung sind. Zumal sie mehrere Kilometer entfernt ist. Ich schätze, es geht dabei mehr um Versicherungsfragen. Ich danke Ihnen, wie immer, für Ihre Dienste. Ritz Sluzarenko, Brandinspektor. Oh Mann.
Memo from their boss.
Did it say anything of note?
Next few days, dropping into the thoroughfare on behalf of Dr. Simmons at Wapiti Station.
Wapiti Station?
Holy crap.
Keep reading.
Oh, I just thought I would maybe, you know, stop there, let the mystery percolate.
My mother always said I would need someone to give me a taste of my own medicine.
They're running a research site out there. He was worried about wildfires.
Someone is writing down our conversations. And now we find out there's a research site out here that we don't know about? What are they researching?
Us. They're researching us.
You think they're studying you and me?
I do, yeah. I mean, maybe it's about studying two strangers who talk every day.
Like, if you put someone in isolation with someone else, what they do?
Yeah, that's what I think.
Well, fuck that.
Agreed.
I think we should allow for the possibility that this is all just a big misunderstanding, but... God, if you saw what you said you did... Fuck, Henry.
Yeah, I saw it.
Okay. So what's next?
Well, I've got an axe, so I can figure out a way to get over the ravine and back towards the site.
Sounds good. Check in when you can, and keep an eye out for anyone following you.
So, das machen wir noch schnell, das macht dann nicht von alleine hier. So. Jetzt speichern wir. Und das war's für diesen Part. Wir sehen uns im nächsten Part. Haut rein und tschüss.